Sit down, sit down. They will bring you guys mentos. Mentos is more expensive, huh? I'm just saying.
Everybody have the gold, Dan?
Yeah.
Mark, you can sit down for like 10 minutes. The gold's still not there.
Because you put the rope down. And the high kicks. Walk my course. I think the high kicks.
No, you didn't.
I'll put this mic on. One time.
Yeah, turn it off.
No, I mean the thing's off a little bit because
I can't.
It's blowing right from my face.
No. Nope. Right on the seat.
Yeah. Why am I seeing it?
All right, look. We need to get started right now, okay? We're 5 minutes late. We've been working, you've written two versions of the same story, right?
Yes.
So your stories are a collection of scenes or small moments, right? I'd like you to think of your scenes as bricks. Bricks. And you're building a house. Or you're building a structure. Okay? And for some of those bricks, we're going to zoom in and focus on making those bricks more elaborate, making them stronger. I'm going to show you that today. At other times, we're going to zoom out. Is to make sure that all the bricks fit together the right way, in a way that creates something that we like, and it creates it the way we want it to be created. So today we're going to think about adding or removing scenes from our story, and also zooming in to elaborate on specific scenes that connect to what the story is really about. So I have an example we're going to work on, and it's a story by one of my friends. Her name is Lucy. In this story, okay, what she learns, her story is about her learning that her dad is kind of on her side and understands her even when she does something wrong. Now in this story, Albert, CJ, you guys paying attention? Right? You shouldn't talk to each other right now. So in this story, Lucy and her sister Allison, right? They're in their yard playing. And their dad has this garden that he loves. Right? It's got vegetables, it's got all these different things, flowers. It's in the backyard, it's pretty big. Right? And they're in the backyard playing. And their dad says, the dad has to go out, and he asks Lucy to water the flowers, to water the garden. So he shows her how to use the hose, okay? And she kind of ignores him. She ignores him as he gives directions on how to use the hose. And then when she's using the hose, you guys have used the hose before, right? Now this hose at her house was super strong. The water pressure was really strong, so when she squeezed the thing, it's like a fire hose, right? And her dad gave her some instructions on how to use it, but she wasn't paying attention. So when she tried to water the garden, right, it was like right? And the dirt's flying everywhere. All of Dad's like precious vegetables that he's been waiting weeks to eat, she's blowing them out of the ground. And then she realizes that it's real fun to shoot her sister with that hose. Right? So she destroys the garden. But when her dad, you know, she expects her dad to be really mad, but he kind of understands, even though she was wrong. So she learns this thing about her dad. And as she's going back, re-envisioning her story and making some changes, she finds a section that she wants to elaborate on. So we're going to look at the before. Can we see that? Can everyone see? James, you can see?
Yes.
All right, so I'll read it to you. This is in her draft, right? Dad motioned Allison and me closer, the new hose tucked under his arm. He began to say, "Girls, you can do the watering for me, but there are a few important rules." Immediately, I looked at Allison and rolled my eyes and puffed out my cheeks, annoyed that he was starting one of his lectures. Allison giggled, but Dad's face was stern when I turned back around. "Okay, okay, Dad," I said quickly. "I'm listening." As my father began another one of his long explanations, I sighed and thought, "Here we go again." Then I began to tune him out, letting my mind wander to what Allison and I would play with the new hose. All right, so this isn't bad, right? But it kind of feels like the author's telling us what happened, right? So as the author, she's asking herself, what's my story really about? Okay, and her story is really about her understanding, her learning that her dad, even when she's wrong, even when she screws up, her dad kind of understands. So she knows that she must ask herself what the story is really about and then use that to choose the scenes that she elaborates on. Okay, so this part where Dad's trying to explain the rules, okay, because part of the deeper meaning of the story is her about her not following the rules, she chooses to elaborate and really zoom in on this part. Okay? So my challenge for you is to tell me how she does that. All right, so I've got the before and after for each of you. Your job is to read, I just read the before to you. You're going to read the after. Then on here, I want you to write down the techniques she uses to zoom in and elaborate and really get us in that moment. Okay? So who can tell us what we're gonna do when I pass this out? Somebody tell me. What are we gonna do? Even back.
Yeah, so to find what
techniques the author used. That's right. We're gonna figure out what techniques the author used. Where can we find the techniques? Up there, right? How to write powerful personal narratives. We got the whole thing up here. Somebody move that.
No, he dropped it.
It's not fixed. It's in the wrong spot. That's not what I would call fixed.
Where was it?
It was here.
It used to be like down there.
So anyway, look. Up top here. These are your techniques. Okay, so you're going to try to figure out what the author did. You take those, pass them around your way. Over here, you pass them around your way. You've got about 1 minute.
What?
Il bun.
I don't speak Korean.
How do we say 1 minute?
But I didn't take one.
Just never mind.
Just never mind? That means 1 minute?
No.
Just never mind.
Schedule? What the schedule?
What?
Why do you need two?
I don't have a
schedule. You're gonna mash it.
Hey guys, look, you're wasting your own writing time by failing to pass out a piece of paper. Yeah. There should be another one.
Got one.
Here you go. So you can write on top of this. You can talk to each other.
Yes,
too. Doesn't matter. You can write on this, you can talk to each other, you've got about a minute left. What is Lucy doing to elaborate, to make it more powerful? So I've got some hints for you. You can peek up here. Got some hints. If you see something highlighted up here, that's because it made me think that something's going on. Something's different. Something's better. I didn't hear any talking, so you can tell me. What's the author doing? I can see it. You're writing it down. Laura knows what's going on. You need a second to tell your partner what you think's happening? All right. 15 seconds to talk. Ready? Go. Okay, stop. I heard all the right answers. Okay, we can sum it up and just say that the author steps into the moment, right? So right here, from the beginning, Dad's face was stern when I turned back around. But then he took one of his deep breaths and relaxed his face. So immediately I know the author right here is climbing right back into that moment to when her dad turned around. And then, through here, she's showing us what happened. Through the tiny actions, small steps her dad went through. Right? He turned around. He took a deep breath. He did this. He bent over. Okay? We also have his exact words. You need to show me that I can feel comfortable leaving you in charge for a little while. Right? These are dad's exact words, right? Got that there. And then down at the bottom, we've got some inner thinking that shows the author is annoyed that her dad is giving this lecture, but also that she wants dad to feel that she's worthy of his trust. Right? So we've got all these things happening. Right? We got time it into the moment with inner thinking, with tiny actions. The author chose to elaborate on this scene because this one connects directly to what the story is really about. Right? So I want you to try it. I want you to open your most recent draft, open to your most recent draft, and then put your thumb on a spot that you want to elaborate on. Okay, and when you find that, put your thumb on it and look up at me.
Can we use the second most recent draft?
Yes. So to let me know you found the spot, I want you to look at the ceiling. When you found the spot, look at the ceiling. You got your thumb on it, your thumb's on the spot, your eyes are on the ceiling. Okay, stretch out your neck. Okay, good. Now, eyes up here. I want you to close your eyes, right, and climb back into that moment. Your eyes are open. I ask you to close them. Okay, your eyes are closed. And climb back into that moment. Okay, think about the actions you're taking. What are the small steps you are going through or the characters in your story are doing? What are those tiny steps? What are you thinking? What are you feeling? What do you see? Right? Go back into the narrator's eyes. And what do you need to do to show this to your reader? Okay, eyes opening up here. I want you to take a minute right now, write some notes into your draft about what you can do to elaborate. Write some notes there about what you can do for that scene. Now, when you get back to your desk, I want you to continue writing this draft, okay, making the changes and elaborating on the scenes that connect to what your story is really about. All right, so try to remember these things. Our tools for zooming in, right? Inner thinking, dialogue. What else? Inner thinking, dialogue, tiny actions. Ready to go? You know what to do?
Yeah.
So your goal should be to finish that second draft today. When you come back on Monday, you will be typing this draft.
Yay.
Typing a new draft.
Used.
Okay, so you gotta finish. We try to finish today. Alright, so back to your desks. Pens moving fast and furiously. I don't know if you do anything fast.
Not bad.
Your golf swing's pretty fast.